Good evening, everyone, and welcome to our annual middle school get-together, as we say here. It's a special occasion for all these young students to meet and also find out what other groups are playing, who's there, and how good they are in comparison to other, as we filter them all to Brockton High School into some of our fine ensembles. So before we start, just a few things that we need to tell you. Number one, no cell phones, okay? They make enough noise and destroy a lot of things, including practice times for children. So please, no cell phones, and any in case of an emergency, the exits are on both sides. Please do not use them all. And you don't have to come in through the center. So we work on that, okay? The other thing, too, is tomorrow night, I know this came together because it's trying to set all this thing up with all these stands. We're going to do our spring concert, and all of our groups perform, including the 9th grade and the 10th grade group for parents, especially if you have any 8th graders coming in. This is where they would go. And then tonight we're going to have a couple of things to demonstrate to you. Just one of them will be our jazz ensemble, a couple of selections to show you what is available for the students. And also the concert band will play just a couple selections. So I know it's two nights in a row, but if you got nothing to do, there's really nothing on television you really want to know. Politicians fighting and the Kardashians, and that's about it, right? So why don't you come down here and see some nice kids instead of those kids always getting in trouble on what is going on. Speaking of that, what is tonight all about? Let me just give you a little quote. Well, Mr. Cardell's out there fixing the noble. And I've lived this quote for many, many years. So for parents, this is for you. Okay? I don't think the children understand. But this is a quote by Plato. He said, "I will teach children music, physics, and philosophy, but most important in music, for in the patterns of the arts, are the keys to all learning." And we are finding out today, as a matter of fact, a great study. I wanted to put this on the screen that I just found out, but we can't do it. Some scientists and neurologists got together and had some children. And with all the machines that we have today, it's amazing what we can figure out. They figured out that students performing, they did two studies. One was a student listening to music, and the other was a student playing a musical instrument. And what was happening through their own mechanics and all of their gears over there, they were seeing that the brain, when the kid was listening to music, was working a little bit, crossing from one side to another. But when kid began to play a musical instrument, the brains were going nuts. Whatever we got inside there, they were jumping from both sides, meaning that the entire brain was being used. And in the world today, we're trying to teach these kids how to what? Focus, process, discipline. Because you better have discipline when you go to colleges. There is nothing more that offers that. And that's why Plato said what he did. And by the way, China and Japan haven't figured this out before American kids. In China and Japan, you have to take music. Now, whether you want to or not, they have figured it out that this whole thing, and that's maybe one of the reasons why music has been tied to math for a great deal. I want you to think about this. When these kids play tonight, or when my kids play tonight, you want to talk about focusing the discipline. Think of the amount of hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of notes those kids have to play, and everyone has to be on the money. Remember, there's an academic A, and there's a music A. In an academic A, you can get one wrong, and you can still get an A. In a music A, one wrong is a failure. I want you to think about this. So the first group to perform would be the Plouffe and East Band under the direction of Mr. Kevin Cardell and Ms. Sarah Wheeler. Thank you.
Thank you very much. We'd like to bring up next Miss Sarah Wheeler, conducting the East End Plouffe Band.
Change for and the Brockton High School Jazz Ensemble is up next. Enjoy.
Next, we'd like to introduce Mr. Macrina and the Brockton High School Senior Jazz Band.
Thank you.
Thank you. Now this ensemble here meets once a week, and we have three of them. We have a middle school, and we also have an all-city. This one, every year this gets re-auditioned. You have to audition for this organization. So parents, the reason why we do it over here, not only to show you what we have, but also the level that the kids need to be here once they get here. So the important is, how do you get up here? You practice. And that's, today they want to look at the instrument, so it doesn't work. I tried that a long time ago, it does not work. Okay? So the next number we're going to play for you, as a matter of fact, I went to Foxwoods to hear this piece of music being played by the person that did it, Brian Setzer. Some of you might remember him in the early days, and now he's running one of the great jazz ensembles in the world. And this tune called Rock This Town. And the great thing about it, well, why I went down there, I did not go there to gamble. I actually went there to hear the lead trumpet player who actually sat in this band many years ago. So it was great to see Brian Scanlon performing with that group. Again, the kids get whatever foundation they need at this high school. They want to go to Harvard, they'll go to Harvard. And if they want to play, depends on what they want to do. You got it right here. Absolutely. Please put your phones away. All the lights are making a noise, okay? I would appreciate that. All the lights. You're here to listen. That's what the kids are here for. All right, thank you. So anyway, here we go. A little bit of Rock This Town. Who's doing solos? Did you pay me for a solo? Here we go. One, two. Thank you. Nicholas and Ryan. Thank you. All right. The Davis and the South Band, under the directions of Mrs. Susan May and Teresa Jovanov.
Thanks very much. Next is Teresa Giovanello from South Middle School.
And let's welcome the West Ashfield North Band under the direction of Mr. Andrew Fantuccio, Maxwell Parker, and Marilyn Amadouris. And you just see the middle school here, there's close to 1,500 kids in the elementary school that we try to handle, like with five people. So Brockton High School is extremely proud. We probably have one of the largest, if not close to the largest program in the state of Massachusetts. And we want to thank you just for the 45 years I've been here. The dedication of, and the love for music in this program, the support, it's been outstanding. And people want to know, how do we keep on doing it? You thank the administrators and all the people, the school committee members and superintendents that have constantly supported this program as long as I've been. But you count the most right out right here, because this is the greatest thing you can, music is one of the greatest things you can offer your children. So anyway, here they are. Mr. Fantucci will start off.
For this group. It's my pleasure to introduce to you actually our newest faculty member here with the music department. And we think he's doing a wonderful job over at the Ashfield School. So please welcome Max Parker.
very much. For our last selection, I would like to welcome up Miss Marilyn Amadori from North.
Advanced Concert Band meets period six. It's a class. It is not an extracurricular activity. They get 6 credits for this. So mandatory practice, homework, basically to get the stuff. We have a 9th grade concert band that all the 9th graders go in there and they meet every other day. Next year, we hopefully to get them in there every single day. And then out of this group here, you have a what we call the Win Ensemble, which is a select group. And that group, I'd like to just congratulate them on winning a silver medal at the Micah Festival the other day. There was some discrepancy, but I didn't want to go there in regards to. But this group has worked extremely hard to achieve that. Even getting up at 5 in the morning, leaving at 5 o'clock in the morning, driving all the way to Bellingham. And performing at 8 o'clock in the morning. So we perform, we also travel. As you know, we performed at Disney, we performed a lot of play jazz ensembles, play in Bermuda, a lot of other places. So basically what we're trying to tell you, this is a great place for these kids. Now, when you see up here, we're one sitting down here. And I can tell you there isn't anyone here that would not say one thing, and that is if they had to do it all again, I always ask them, what would they do? Practice more. And that's just not comforting. So again, I emphasize it. The best way to get them going, set aside half an hour, consistency, get rid of the phone, and everything will be great. So the kids will come in next year, we'll move them in, we'll say it's all by auditions. You have to meet proficiency in the 9th grade. Just can't come down after 9, you know, we figure after 6-7 years, If you still don't know which end to blow the horn in, I think it's for you. Okay, so it's not, parents, it's not an afternoon activity. Okay, we also have the marching band, which is the halftime show. So there's a lot of things that the kids can really get, you know, get involved in. This is a great program to hear. So we're going to do a couple of numbers tomorrow night. We're going to be performing with the other band in here. And the Wind Ensemble we're performing, but we're not none of the tunes tonight. We just don't have the time. But you can see basically, you know, what's going on here in regards to the level of our performance. So we'd like to start with the, we're going to do this tomorrow night, and obviously this is the concert band, we'll play this tomorrow night. We'd like to start with the Common Suite, a little classical music. We give them an introduction to everything. We're going to do three movements, so wait till the third movement to clap, at the end of the third movement, okay? Music 101, when to clap or when not to clap. Here it is, ready? You'll be in an MCAS test, so pay attention. A conductor usually finishes it and puts his hands down like this. As John Williams will say, let us finish. Because there's always somebody who wants to start clapping early. There's no price for that, by the way. So usually the conductor drops the hands, that is your sign that you can clap. Usually during sections, you don't clap. As long as the hands are up. Okay, doesn't mean it. And then we finish it off with a classic that everybody's enjoyed a great deal. We're going to do this after, and that's the theme to the Pirates of the Caribbean.
Thank you.
we save you a little money. I have to go to the pubs. You see, I read here. And for our final love, for everyone, I enjoyed this movie a great deal, and this music, no matter how many times we played it. These are all the themes from Pirates of the Caribbean.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. I hope your children have an opportunity to come in and join one of these groups someday. And it's very easy. Just keep them practicing, and it's a lot of fun. And that's the important thing. Thank you so much. We come by tomorrow night. I know it's two nights in a row. We got a whole school thing. Don't forget our musical is coming up in May, and also our Pops concert in the 25th, I think. Okay. Thank you so much for coming. And if you have any questions, call the music program. We're more than happy to help you out. Thank you.